11 days, 11 more days. Oh man, kind of nervous. Got two more shows. Feel bad for Arnold too. I mean, I don't know what he's gonna be doing. And the show's still about me, at least for the next couple weeks, you know? Should text Reese. I don't exactly know what I'm supposed to be doing this show. Oh, 11 more days. June 1st. I didn't think this day would come. So many emotions. Start my day the same way every day. Get my cup of coffee and my All Right Show mug. Don, have you seen my mug?
I haven't seen it, but if Reese was around here a little earlier ago looking for mugs, he didn't walk away with it, did he?
He shouldn't have. That's my mug. It's got my name on it.
Well, you know Reese. I do know Reese.
You haven't seen my mug.
No, I haven't seen it.
I didn't want to say anything, but they gave me this mug. And actually, it's kind of a nice mug. I think I'm going to keep it.
I've always found that when I pray about something, God answers my prayers. There's one time I was working in my garage. I dropped my glasses, couldn't find them. Prayed about it, stepped on them, found them right away. Unfortunately, it wasn't answered the way I wanted to. Maybe we should just pray together or not.
So. I suppose.
Lord, I just want you to be with Josh and his family as they begin this new journey. We just pray that you bless everything they do out there, that you'll answer all their prayers, and that you would just bless his ministry, that it'll go further, more abundant than what you could ever dream of. We just thank you for everything you've done here at Redemption. Continue to bless him in the future. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, thanks, Don. I gotta go find my mug and find Reese.
It's here someplace.
Yeah, I don't want to get into any of the drama, but I heard that today is Arnold's first day leading the All Right Show, and I don't think they've told Watt yet.
Arnold, have you seen Reese?
Stupid mug.
Hey Josh, didn't know you were coming in today. Just getting ready for Arnold taking over.
I don't care what the governor says, make it happen. Yes, money is not an issue. I already told you. Just get it done. Bye.
Good morning, sir.
Oh my gosh, Kyla. Good. Glad you're here.
Okay.
Here we go. We got to move. We got the All Right Show.
Okay, there's your pudding.
Thank you.
It's room temperature.
Just like I like it.
I have three voicemails.
Let's go.
I need you to sign here.
Okay.
Just at the top. And then you have this fan mail came in this morning.
Excellent.
Hey, have you talked to Watt? There's a couple people looking for you, but I know he's been waiting in the lobby for you, so we could go in there.
No, let's go to the office. Okay. Let's do this.
Okay,
OMG,
is there anything else?
You are so cool. I like, want to be like you when I grow up. Will you sign this? Yes. Done.
Okay.
Here.
Is there anything else?
My glasses are dirty.
Oh,
please clean them.
Okay.
Kyla, backpack. Help me with this jacket, please. We gotta get going. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Coat!
He is driving me crazy. Have you seen the hair? The hair always has to be perfect. It's like sticking straight up or sticking straight out. And then the glasses. Have you seen the glasses? They're on his, like, take the glasses off. And he's always trying to set me up with someone. Like, come on, stop it. Have you even met these people? Like, come on. Reese is just so, oh my goodness. And he's late. Can you just be on time for one of it? Pick a time, pick a plan, and be done. Like, be there, be square. No, he's always an hour and 45 minutes late. He rules the world. But yes, to answer your question, Yes, I'm kind of sad that Watt's leaving.
Where's my coffee?
Yes, sir, right here.
Kyle, thank you. Man. Just how I like it. This intern really knows how to kiss butt. I like it. Makes a great coffee.
Honestly, I don't even know how he likes his coffee. Last week I put 2-week-old creamer in it, said it was the best thing ever. I don't even think he has taste buds.
Take my pudding. It was good. I don't want you eating any of it. Thank you. Out of here. Kylo, where are my glasses? Thank you. My forehead's not just gonna cover itself. Let's go.
Okay.
You have to talk louder. I can't help you with that right now. I can't help you. That was not my job. Kyle was supposed to take care of that. That was on his list. I can't come in there right now. Okay, give me 20 seconds and I will come help you because I don't know where Kyle is. Okay, what was your question?
Is Ruiz a good leader?
He's all right, but this all right show, let's just say this. It's changed him.
What else we got going right now?
Okay, I need
Kyle,
you.
Kyle, did you get those guests and those t-shirts?
Yeah, hold on. Yes.
Hurry.
Okay, somebody was asking for this. I need you to autograph this in here.
You have a pen? I need a pen.
I'm sorry, sir.
Kyle, I need you to keep it together. We have a show to do in like 5 minutes.
Okay.
Let's go.
Okay.
Oh, hey, man. Hey, what's seeing up? Your brother?
No.
And is that my mug?
I don't know.
Reese!
I'm actually really worried about Watt. I've just seen a lot of unhealth in his number. I think he's trying to cover up for some true feelings.
Donna Kaplan!
See what I mean?
Kyla, yes. Read me last week's comments, please, on the All Right Show.
Okay, from last week, Wild Pegasus Horse Girl, do you mean a words with random placement? Wild Pegasus Horse Girl again, DTA How Me Speaks. Jeremiah Power, LOLOLOLOLOLOLOL. Jeremiah Power, heart sign, heart sign, heart sign, heart sign. Katya, LOL Irene. Wild Pegasus Horse Girl, why are you yelling? Question mark. Jeremiah Power, because I can. LOLOLOLOLOLOL. Jeremiah Power, what if your crush doesn't have a phone? Wild Pegasus Horse Girl, it called go to their house and stand outside and talk. Wild Pegasus Horse Girl again, it only weird if you think it weird. Jeremiah Power, that weird. Wild Pegasus Horse Girl, I weird so I know. Jeremiah Power, I do think it's weird. Jeremiah Power, weird girls in the house.
Enough, forget it. Okay. Get a hold of this Jeremiah Powers, whoever this person is.
Yes.
And Wild Pegasus Horse and shut them down. I do not want to see any of their comments anymore. Isn't Jeremiah Power like a middle-aged man at our church?
So,
I don't understand how he got in this chat room.
Okay.
Fix it.
I'll find it. I'll take care of it.
Thank you. Gotta get my computer to turn on here. See if the computer doesn't even work. I'm out of here.
Do I want to be here forever?
Yeah, babe, I just needed someone to talk to. Yeah, I'm pretty sad. I don't know. I'm here 11 more days, and they're acting like I'm gone already. And I'm pretty sure they gave my mug to Arnold. I don't know. I thought Arnold was a good choice, but I don't know if he has the creative juices to fill my shoes. I mean, who's gonna name segments from now on? I mean, the game, the guests. Arnold can't come up with that. Stuff's gold. I don't know. I'm in a weird space. I'm sad. Well, thanks for talking. I'll see you when I get home. Love you, babe. Bye.
Hola, mijo.
Hola.
Can I come in?
Yes.
I heard you being sad.
Yeah.
It's okay. You know what I do when I'm sad?
What do you do?
I pray. Can I pray for you?
Yes, please.
I was told I was going to be on the All Right Show this week, right? I
do not have time.
Hey!
I'm a busy man. I have the All Right show to film. I do not have time for this. Ridiculous.
Pretty good.
Good. What's up?
I was told by Ruiz I was going to be on the All Right show this week.
Oh, for this week?
Yeah.
Okay. Did he say what he was going to have you do?
Yeah. I think he said I could just, like, shout my friends out. Will, Hans, Cohen, Caleb, like, Brock, Jalen, Miles, you know, those people.
Okay. Whose group are you?
I'm in Eric and Ari's group.
Okay. Well, how about this? I will talk to him. Mm. And then get it all confirmed, and we'll just give you a call. All
right, cool. Thank you. Mom, I got rejected. Can you come pick me up? Yeah, it's a little bust.
We've come to the end of the road. You can't let go. It's unnatural.
You a mug, okay? Just listen, I didn't know how to tell you, but Arnold's gonna preach this week, so he's doing the sermon portion. Okay,
I'm sorry. When were you gonna tell me? Now?
Well,
minutes before the show?
Yeah. Arnold, are you ready?
Yeah, actually, that's what I'm working on right now. I kind of want to run it by you guys.
Walk me through it.
Yeah, yes. Walk us through it.
All right. So this week, we've been on that theme of you'll be all right if,
right,
fill in the blank, right? Mm-hmm. So this week I'm thinking, you'll be all right if you pray.
Hmm.
What do you think about that?
I forgot to pray before I ate this, but
yeah.
Lord, thanks for this meal.
Done. Yeah. So I feel like prayer is one of those things, right, where everybody could probably benefit from doing it more. But it's one of those things we don't do for some reason.
Okay.
But the benefits of it are like super, I mean, even like secular scientists and sociologists say prayer can lead to, benefits in mental health, even physical health and spiritual health. And so the Bible certainly agrees with that. And so I kind of just want to talk a little bit about prayer.
Hmm.
And that's kind of the topic that I want to talk about.
What passage are you coming out of?
Yeah. So I'll get there in a minute. I need to kind of do a little bit of a setup, I
think. Okay.
So I want to basically talk about the two P's of prayer. There's two P's that I want to talk about. The first one is posture, and the second one is practice. So the posture and the practice of prayer, right? So
I like it.
Yeah. Sweet. Sorry. I'm glad. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about it. So when I'm talking about posture, most of the time when we talk about posture, we think of a physical posture. Like when we pray, we do one of these, we fold our hands, and we bow our heads and close our eyes.
Sure.
And so I want to talk about that because it's not just a physical posture, but a spiritual posture, a posture of the heart.
Okay.
Now, the physical posture is important because our bodies oftentimes follow, our hearts oftentimes follow what our bodies do.
Yeah, I think we've experienced that. With Zoom calls, like when I'm in my pajamas laying down, I'm not as productive as my posture.
Yes, exactly. And that's true of anything in your life, but also in prayer.
How much are you going to stress that with like students?
Yeah, I think, it's not a do or die thing. You can pray wherever, whenever, but there is certain things about the way that we normally pray that I think are helpful in talking about the heart posture.
Perfect.
Of prayer.
Yeah.
Right. So when we I want to start out with this. The posture of prayer begins when you are in a moment and you say, this moment is too big for me. It's too big for me. Whether it's overjoyed, you're overjoyed. This moment is too big for just me. Or whether you're actually worried or fearful, you say, this moment is too big for me. And in that moment, you are already entering into the posture of prayer, right?
I like it.
And so the idea of hands coming together, you're saying, there's nothing I can do. There's nothing to be done. I need to cease from doing things with my hands. And I need to come to this place where it's like, this moment is too big for me. So that's the beginning. But that's not the only thing.
That's great, Arnold.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Thank you. But that's not the only thing, right? So there's more to this posture. Because there's a moment where you have to say, this moment is too big for me, and I need to take this to God. Hmm. Right? And so when we bow our heads, we fold our hands and we bow our heads, we're bowing, we close our eyes, we bow in reverence to God, because we realize that he's the one that we need to be praying to. He's the one who is going to be involved in this. He's the one who we can go to because he cares. You know, when you bow, you are putting yourself in a place of vulnerability. And so there's this posture of, I'm ceasing what I'm doing. I'm bowing in recognition that I can be vulnerable and I can offer my worries, because worry is always an opportunity to pray. Every moment throughout your day, every moment throughout your week, worry is an opportunity to pray.
I've been learning that today.
Yeah. Seriously. I'm like, pray, Bob, would you? So that was the first P?
Well, there's one more part of this P. That's where the scripture comes in.
Okay.
All right, and I'm going to be quick.
Because you'll have to be quicker when you do this for the show.
Okay.
We got 10 minutes. So.
Okay. All right, I'm going to be quick. So the scripture is going to be out of Luke chapter 22. The context is Jesus is eating dinner with his disciples right before he's about to be betrayed and crucified. And he says this to Peter, who's named Simon. And he says, Simon, Satan has asked to sift all of you as wheat. But I have prayed for you, Simon, that your faith would not fail. And when you have turned back, strengthen your brothers. Now, the reason why this is important is because it introduces another important component to the posture element of prayer. And that is that you must look at prayer as a process, as a way of entering into a story that God is writing, right? Why don't we pray most of the time? It's because we don't believe anything will come of it, or we've been disappointed by prayer in the past, mm-hmm. right? Well, here is Jesus, and there's something very interesting about this, because in a sense, Jesus's prayer fails. Peter is going to immediately go, Peter's faith is going to fail when he denies Christ. Three times he denies him. He wimps out, his faith fails, he fails. Jesus's prayer here doesn't seem to hold true. And if we push pause on the moment right there, we would say, Jesus, not even Jesus's prayer got answered. Right? But yet, God's writing a bigger story. You see, because the story continues. Jesus has a resurrection that's still got to happen. Jesus still has a moment of Peter where he's going to come to him and redeem him. He's going to say, do you love me? Then feed my lambs. Strengthen your brothers. Do these things. But if we were to pause there at that moment, we would say that it never came true. But in fact, Jesus' prayer comes true in an enormous way, and Peter ends up leading the church, being the leader of the original church, which is amazing. Peter's faith did not ultimately fail, and so what we see in this story is God writing a story that is not like we would expect. So the important part of this is you enter into the posture of, what is God doing? If it doesn't get answered like you want, what is God doing next? Because this is not the end.
And then so what's your second part?
Yeah, so the second part, that's it. This is it. The practice is for, I'm not going to explain a lot. It's for small groups. But the practice of it is, you can't just think about prayer. You got to do it. So where are you?
That.
Where are you? Do you never pray? Then pray 10 seconds. Literally pray 10 seconds. You know, if you pray 1 minute, pray 5 minutes. And so I want to open up with these questions, the practice of prayer in the small groups. And the first question I have is, if worry is an opportunity to pray, what things are you worried about and therefore have an opportunity to pray about?
Repeat that again.
If worry is an opportunity to pray, what things are you personally worried about and therefore have an opportunity to pray about?
Cool. I know it's not my segment, but you mind if I step in?
Sure.
I may be asking a little different. I would just say, what are some reasons why we don't pray? Just kind of, I think it says the same thing, asks the same thing.
So yeah.
I don't know if that's okay.
No, I like it.
Cool.
What are some reasons we don't pray?
We can do both questions or we just do one. I mean, what are reasons we don't pray? Yeah. What are areas of worry that we can pray about? Because that's what we're supposed to do in areas of worry.
Yeah.
I like it.
You good with that?
I'm good with it.
Sure.
So I invite people.
I want to invite.
Yeah. No, that's good.
Well, okay.
I appreciate it.
All right. So we're going to go on. We're on in like 2 minutes. I got to check on our guest. And then you're going to do, just be quick with that. Boom, 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 pop. Kids, you know, they got
quicker than I was here.
They're going to be on the chats just being like, I'm dumb. And I'll be like, focus.
Jeremiah, over the comments.
Jeremiah Powers, we're trying to shut him down, but he's a monster. So he'll be in there. So any stutter you say, pick up on it. If you say together but united, picked up on it. So
it was
clear.
Beautiful though. What you just said was beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay.
I love it.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
We need to pray. So you'll be all right if you
pray.
Pray. Okay. Perfect.
Actually, what do you want to pray?
Sure.
Let's pray right now.
Before the show. That'll be good.
Jesus, thank you for your word. Thank you for the story that you bring us into. And thank you for your grace that extends beyond Peter and his knucklehead life of never trusting you fully, and yet you giving him all this power and prestige and ability time after time, even when he failed. So God, help us. We need your grace, and prayer is this great gift you've given us to experience your grace and to talk with you and to enter in, like Arnold said, into something bigger than us. So help us to see prayer as that sweet gift of invitation to enter into something bigger than us, someone bigger than us, you, and a story bigger than any story we could ever write on our own. So God, help us. We need you. We ask this in your son's name. Amen.
Amen.
Let's do this. I'll let facilities clean that up.
Still can't believe you took my mug.
What? If you don't stop whining about that,
I swear.
Let's go. Hey, ladies. We ready?
No.
They're ready.
Thank you.
Places, ladies.
Okay.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay. Good. Print it. I love it. Okay, so here's how this is going to go down. Remind me your names again.
Caroline.
Jenna.
Cameron.
Isabel.
And you guys are in?
Seventh grade.
Okay. I think I can remember that. If I get your names wrong on the show, I'm sorry. Okay. I have a lot to do. I don't have time to deal with this.
Okay.
So here's what we're going to do. Remember, you're going to be just around the corner when I say the guest. Right? Watt used to say, but I said, the guest, okay? That's when you're going to come out, okay? And I'm just going to ask you how you're doing in quarantine, what things are like. If you have any interesting stories, that'd be the time to bring it out, okay? And remember, smile. Like, don't, not smile. Okay? Smile, look happy. Got it? Kyle, you got them?
Got it.
It's rolling time, baby. It is go time, ladies
and gentlemen.
Let's do
this. Let's do this.
It's going to be good.
It's going to be good. Real good.
That's what I said.
I was just saying it a little better and louder.
All right.
Yes. Excited. A little nervous.
Let's go make the money.
Oh, I love my...
Well, I was going to sit here.
Did I sit here?
Well, just for this time. It doesn't. I mean, it really doesn't matter. I don't think.
It does. It does.
I mean, but it doesn't.
But it does.
Makeup, where we at?
Sorry.
Glasses, please. Make me look good, not that I need it. Thank you.
You got this, sir.
I do not need your encouragement. I am the star. I know this. Let's go.
Make sure you get my left side good today, too.
Anyways, are we ready to roll?
Oh, wait, what do I look at?
I mean, it doesn't, you'll be like someone in the scene, but I would just kind of, I mean, you might be separate than us. You might be like
out?
I mean, not out, but like, we're not going to see you as much.
I mean, it says what? I still don't get it.
Yeah, but it's my cup, so.
It doesn't say Reese and Reese.
We're about to shoot what?
I know, I've done the show. I know how it works.
We're all right. We just gotta go. I'll do the clap, okay?
No, the clap is me. It's been me.
Hey, are you guys ready to roll? Can we get this show
I'm
on
ready.
The road?
Yes, we are ready.
Okay.
Game faces.
All right, here we go.
Where do
Game
I look?
Five.
Reese, I don't know.
Four. Where. Three.
I don't know what to
do.
Dun 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 d